In this video, Ahmad is going to show you how you can delay your Facebook pixel to build a higher quality audience in your Facebook ads. All the more coming up. Hello there and welcome back to another video of MeasureSchool.com teaching you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, but today we have Ahmad from Sierwag on the channel. He is the web analytics specialist there and he's going to show us how we can refine our Facebook audience by delaying our Facebook pixel. So in the end, we have a higher quality audience to do, for example, retargeting to. Now we got lots to cover, so Ahmad, take it away.
Thanks, Julian. My name is Ahmad and I'm the web analytics specialist at Sierwag. Today I'm going to create a Facebook audience of people who have stayed at least 5 seconds on my webpage. The reason I'm doing that is because it gives me a better quality audience by excluding those who have clicked on a link by mistake or just closed the page immediately and didn't have the chance to even look at the page or see the branding or see the offer on the page. We can use this audience for retargeting purposes and hopefully we can get better results by advertising to a better quality audience. Let's begin by creating our base Facebook tag. For this, let's go to Tag Manager and create a new custom HTML tag. I'm clicking on the tag, new, and then CHTML for custom HTML, and then Facebook base pixel. Now I use the custom HTML as a tag type and copy paste my code, my pixel code from Facebook to the tag itself. Now I want the Facebook base tag to fire immediately on all pages. So I set the trigger to all pages and save the Facebook base pixel tag. That was easy, wasn't it? Let's preview the tag and see how it actually performs on our website. Now, Google Tag Manager is in peer review mode and we can go back to our website and refresh the page. As you can see, our custom HTML Facebook base pixel has fired one time, and here in my Facebook pixel helper, I can also see that the page view with my pixel has been fired. Now let's create a custom event for this Facebook pixel that fires 5 seconds after the page load. For this, let's go to Google Tag Manager and first of all, create a trigger. We want to create a trigger that fires 5 seconds after the page load. Luckily for us, there is a built-in trigger inside Google Tag Manager, which is a timer trigger. We can choose the trigger type as timer, put the interval, which is 5,000 milliseconds, which is equals 5 seconds, and then limit it to fire only once. If we put 10 here, this trigger fires every 5 seconds for 10 times, but we only need it to fire once. Now we need to set the conditions for this trigger. We want this trigger to fire on all pages. That's why I'm going to set whenever the page path matches regular expression dot star. And dot star in regular expression means basically everything. Okay, so this timer trigger fires just once after 5 seconds on all pages. Let's give it a name, timer 5 seconds, and save it. Now we have our timer, let's go to tag and create a tag that fires the Facebook event. Tags, a new tag. Again, this is a custom HTML tag for Facebook and it fires after 5 seconds. For the tag configuration, we choose the custom HTML tag type. And here we need to type exactly like this. First of all, because it's a piece of JavaScript, and then FBQ track custom, because it's a custom event that we've created. It's not one of the standard Facebook events, and we can name it whatever we want. In this case, let's use 5 seconds, so we can identify it in Facebook ads interface. Now, we're going to link this tag to the trigger that we've just built. So this piece of code fires 5 seconds after each page load. Let's save it. And let's preview our container. We can either hit preview button here or hit refresh while we're on the preview mode. Now let's go back to the website and refresh the page. As you can see, we only have the Facebook base pixel, and then just after 5 seconds, this new tag fires. If we look at the page view, we can see that the base pixel and this other tag, they fired on the page view, but 5 seconds after that, GTM timer has fired, and with that, our 5 seconds tag has fired. If we check the Facebook pixel helper, we can also see that the page view has fired, and also our 5 seconds new event. Now that we have created our events and pixel base pixel, and we are seeing that they are firing and Facebook pixel helper is showing that they are firing, we also need to go to Facebook to ensure that Facebook is receiving these events. Now here in the Facebook events manager, I'm in the test events tab, okay? And as you can see, it's receiving activity, it's receiving page views, and it's also receiving 5 seconds events. If I clear the activity and refresh this page again and come back here, we can see in real time that first it received a page view, and after 5 seconds, it receives our 5 seconds event, okay? Now the final piece that we need to ensure is to come to Google Tag Manager and for our Facebook base pixel, set something named tag firing priority, because we always want our base pixel, which contains the initiation part of the Facebook pixel, to happen before any other event that we send afterwards. We need to click on advanced setting and give a higher number like 10. To the tag firing priority, and then save the tag. Any tag with a higher priority fires before any other tag with lower priority. So in this case, our base pixel always fires before our event, because this is just a piece of code that needs the initiation pixel to be there in order to perform. Now that we have our tag and trigger set up properly, we can go back to our Facebook Ads Manager within the Facebook Pixel interface and create audiences. We choose the account, we choose the pixel, and then we can choose to create an audience of people who have stayed for more than 5 seconds, for at least 5 seconds. And then we can set for how many days do we want this audience. So the people who have stayed for 5 seconds in the last 7 days, we can give the audience a name and save it. That's it. Now it's time for you to go and try it out yourself. Thank you for watching. Bye.
All right, so there you have it. This is how you can delay your Facebook pixel to, in the end, build a higher quality audience. Now, if you like this video, then definitely give us a thumbs up and also subscribe to our channel right over there, because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.